Welcome to WatchGuard Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today's story is March Patch Day. It's the second Tuesday of the month, so you can probably guess what I'm going to talk about: Microsoft and Adobe patches. As you know, the second Tuesday of the month is the cyclical regular patch day for both Microsoft and Adobe. So let's jump right into this month's updates. Microsoft is the big one and the important one you really need to focus on this month. Microsoft released fixes for 64 different security vulnerabilities that affect a wide range of their packages. Both the server and client versions of all supported Windows versions are affected by some vulnerabilities. They've released updates for both their browsers, Internet Explorer and Edge, Office, of course, Teams, SharePoint, NuGet, and a number of other Microsoft-related products. Of those 64 vulnerabilities, 17 are rated as critical. That means they allow remote code execution, sometimes without any user interaction at all. So a pretty big deal. Now, apparently four of these vulnerabilities were publicly known. In fact, I've talked about one of them yesterday. When I talked about a zero-day Chrome exploit in yesterday's video, I mentioned that the attackers that were exploiting it also were exploiting a Windows vulnerability, specifically a Windows 7 vulnerability. This update fixes that particular vulnerability, as well as a second one that attackers have been leveraging in the wild. This means these updates are very important for you to go and download and install as soon as possible. Now, for all your clients, I recommend you just have automatic updates enabled so that downloads and the installation of these updates happens automagically. Now, servers are a bit different. You probably should test any production server patches before applying those. But for this month's patches, you definitely need to get to them pretty quickly, especially the critically rated ones, and double so for those two vulnerabilities that are being exploited in the wild. Now, the good news is Adobe Patch Day is a bit less newsworthy. They only released updates for two products, Adobe Photoshop being the big one, but also one kind of lesser used product as well. The good news is these are both priority 3 updates, which essentially means that there's really no news of anyone exploiting these, and they're actually kind of exploit vectors that we don't see wild attackers using that often. That doesn't mean they're not important, but that does mean that Adobe says you can patch them at your convenience. That said, if you use Adobe products like Photoshop, I do recommend you update them as soon as possible, just to get the update over with. Anyways, it's a busy patch day as usual. Be sure to go get those Microsoft updates as soon as you can, and thanks for watching. We'll be right back.